Ladies and gentlemen, to more WCW Saturday Night. Attention hotline fans, we've been talking about this one all day. There is a major wrestling superstar, a virtual icon, if you will, who's on the verge of calling it quits. There's so much politicking going on between the NWO, the New World Order, and WCW World Championship Wrestling. I think this guy has just had it up to wherever. He's a man that has been around for a long time. He's worked on top of this profession for so many, many years. Why would he be calling it quits? Is this the end of his career, or may he be leaving for someplace else? I've got that red-hot story all night tonight, running off until midnight at 1-900-909-9900. Call right now.
Our thanks to Mean Gene, who's back in our locker room area, and, of course, the man on the hotline every Saturday up until midnight. Only on the WCW Wrestling Hotline. Well, Dream, are you ready for a fight here? Because you know how he approaches his matches.
Yeah, he will tie you to the tree of woe. And he now is surrounded by controversy. Now, get this. I'm going to try to step lightly on this for the layman out there. He's surrounded by controversy he's not used to right now, brought into his house, because I believe, and we're going to see, as you said, maybe a little bit of his laundry has been drug out on the street. You know what I mean?
Talking about controversy, just wait.
Okay, but you know what I'm saying? So, that's big. That's big.
Taskmaster Kevin Sullivan, along with Jimmy Hart, to meet Prince Iaukea.
Jimmy Hart, what is he doing in our industry? How did he get here? This guy's a snake in the grass, Jimmy Hart. He runs with a horse that's in the lead. You know what I mean? I've never seen a jockey jump from one horse to the other horse so fast. Man, I'm telling you, him and that Sonny Bono.
Sonny Ono.
I hear you.
Whose ultimate dragon will face Dean Malenko at Starrcade, where we may unify all the belts, all nine of them.
He's a raggedy mort. I tell you.
Boy, he is. Oh, my goodness. The steel steps, those are so heavy. Solid steel steps, and now.
This don't look good.
Oh my goodness, head first.
That don't look good at all for this young man.
That'll chop that crop of hair right off the top of his head is what that'll do.
He's an angry man, but he's always been an angry man. I'm not talking about him. Well, he's screeching like a woman.
Right hand to the face, down on the apron. The Prince Iaukea now down on the floor. Wow, it always seems to be like this around Starrcade time. You know, end of the year.
It's been like this for about the last year here, boy. I'm telling you, right.
But I mean, even so, you know, because for years, just to be put on the Starrcade car was an honor.
Yeah, that would be it.
That was your Super Bowl.
Yeah, good.
You work
bigger.
Hard all year, and if you're a top superstar, you're going to be on Starrcade.
Yeah.
And when you're on there, it's a big deal.
Yeah.
Now the two biggest, Hogan and Piper, will finally settle the score, at least attempt to, on Sunday, December 29th.
You think about it a minute as Taskmaster goes ahead and put him to rest. Just saying, the outcome of this was never in doubt. You see a very honorary man. Yeah, but think about this a minute. Who would ever thought back in 1983 that Hogan and Piper would headline Starrcade in 96?
Well, that is a great point.
Yeah. Better duck here. Watch out. The Taskmaster ragtag this guy. Not only Tree of Woden, double belly welly shot, angry, angry man. Taskmaster, I believe his laundry's now been strung out in the street. Let's go to Tony Giovanni, who's pointing at me now.